Hi guys, today from the Paradise Island in the Bahamas. Today I will tell you how to be lucky. Stay with me till the end of this video. We'll have a contest and something to win. I am not at a party. This is the Nassau Airport. This is how you are welcomed in the Bahamas. How to be lucky. I often hear from you, I often read in the comments under my videos, and people generally say very often that yes, you need certain capabilities, you need certain skills in order to be successful in life, in order to have success in business, but it is generally a lot about luck. You just need to get lucky, to be lucky in order to have success in life and to do great things in business. And all these people who achieved big things, who achieved great things in business, they somehow had this strike of fate. They just became lucky. And this event allowed them to be so successful. And now I have to disappoint you, because being lucky, it's also a skill. There are just people who don't have the skill to be lucky, and there are other people who have the skill to be lucky. And you may say, but how? I mean, being lucky, this is just random, yeah? This is a good chance. This is independent of our actions, of what we do or what we are. But I have to tell you, no, it's not true. You actually have the power to improve or to increase the probability of lucky strikes, of lucky events in your life. But most people don't know about that. And most people think they need to wait for a strike of fate and they can't do anything about that. This is independent of them. And I will tell you a personal story from my childhood or from my youth in order to prove one of the points I want to tell you. I was a Polish scout at that time. I was living in Poland. It was my youth before we moved to Germany. And it was an international camp. It was a camp of Polish and German scouts. And it was the time where, you know, you start being interested in the opposite sex and you start the first friendships with the other sex and so on and so on. And as so happened, the most beautiful girl in the camp was a German girl. And almost all the Polish scouts, they didn't speak German, but I did. So I was pretty successful in striking a friendship with her and getting close to her. Yeah, it was like a little innocent love story just for the duration of the camp. And of course, other scouts, Polish scouts, were jealous about that. And one of the scouts said something like, well, he's a lucky bastard because he speaks German. And now think about that. Was I lucky that I spoke German, or was I prepared, or I had the skill to speak German, and this skill helped me to be much more successful than all the other scouts in that situation. So what we learned from that? We learn that if you are prepared to capitalize on an opportunity, then you can get lucky. You can be lucky, right? You can provoke this strike of luck. But you need to see this opportunity and you need to be prepared for that opportunity. It is the same with, you know, especially in the tech companies, in the Facebooks, Twitters, and so on of our times, Instagrams of our times. People say, you know, the creators, the founders of the companies, they were just lucky because they were at the right time, in the right place, and knew the right people. Yes, that's right. But many people were in the same place, in the same time, and knew the same people. And they didn't get lucky. Why not? Because they didn't have the same skills and preparation to be able to capitalize on that opportunity. For example, one of the billionaires in my upcoming book, The Billion Dollar Secret, that I have interviewed for that book, Michał Sołowow. He was chosen the best Polish entrepreneur of the post-communist Poland. He capitalized on the opportunity that arose in the early 90s in Poland after the communism has fallen and suddenly free market was created. And very favorable laws and tax laws for business existed. And he had the skills and the willingness and also the preparation to max out on that opportunity. And millions of other people who also had the same opportunity. They were at the same time, in the same place. They had also the same rules and the same laws applied to them. They weren't able to capitalize on that to that extent. And then they say, well, he got lucky. No, he had the same opportunity, but he was just more skillful to use that opportunity. So I will tell you now several things that you can do in order to improve your ability to be lucky in your life and in business. Several tools that you can use. One of the tools is to be open for the opportunities, to watch out for them and to be attentive in order to spot the opportunity, to recognize the opportunity where it arises. This is very important, right? If you go through the world with your eyes turned inwards, if you look into yourself, into your business, into what you do, and don't look outside, don't look to the people, don't watch the world outside you and scan it for arising opportunities, you may miss most of the opportunities. This is one thing. The other thing is you can surround yourself by people who are lucky in their life or in their business, right? Why? Because apparently they have a skill set to be lucky, to somehow use the opportunities, to notice the opportunities, to use the opportunities and to capitalize on them. And you may not be able to verbalize what it is concretely or what it is in detail, what they do or how they think, the attitude that helps them to be lucky. But there is something that you may pick up by just being with them, talking to them, and it may rub off on you, and you may become also a lucky bastard, so to say, in your life or in business. It is the old rule of you are the average of five people you are surrounded by, right? If these people are lucky bastards, you will become a lucky bastard in the long term as well. So this is another strategy. Then you can provoke lucky events by going to places where luck can strike, right? For example, I will give you some example we can work on. Let's say you want to get lucky with that somebody invites you to a business, let's say cryptocurrency business that will grow to millions or maybe billions in value, and you want to get lucky by just somebody pulling you into that business, right? Into that project, and then become extremely rich with that. Let's say you would like to be lucky in that respect, right? How can you provoke it? Just go to crypto conferences where people pitch their projects, where people look for team members, for business partners, and so on. They build their teams, and you may end up in a room with a team of people who are creating, let's say, the next Google, the next Facebook, or whatever. It may be a stroke of fate, it may be random, it may be good chance, but you are definitely increasing your chances of this happening if you go to a place where this can happen, right? And then they may offer you a job, a partnership, a business partnership, or maybe an investment opportunity. And the other tool you can use is actually to create opportunities where luck can happen, right? if you create such an opportunity, like going to an event is kind of that strategy, but it is a much broader strategy to stay with the same example, right? If you want to get invited to such a project, why don't you send your, I don't know, your skills, your wishes, and your vision to, let's say, 100 promising projects via email, saying, don't you look for a business partner or something, right? Why don't you create a website where you describe your vision, your skill set, and say, you know, I'm looking for business opportunities in the crypto space, looking for partnerships, looking for businesses that I would like to work with. Why don't you do that? You would increase the chances of somebody offering you a partnership, offering you business considerably by doing that. You just create an opportunity, an open window. You open the door for somebody to walk in through that door. You understand? Frank Hasenfratz, Canadian billionaire and auto parts manufacturer, told me, the more I work, the more luck I have. It's just clear. The more you do in that direction, the more you work in this direction, the more you are prepared for arising opportunities, and the more your perception sharpens also for the arising opportunities, so you can perceive them, you can catch them. And of course, the more diligent you are with your work, the better you can capitalize on them. It's so simple. As you see, I am in the Hotel Atlantis in the Bahamas. Really nice spot. They have a great water park. There is a lot of activities, entertainment or sports opportunities. I recommend to you, if any of you are in the Bahamas, visit that place. You will love it. I can see you like this video. Give me a thumb up, subscribe below, and don't forget to hit the bell button in order not to miss my other videos. I invite you to leave a comment. Tell me what is your experience, what are your thoughts, what is your perspective on this topic. And I promised you a competition at the beginning of this video. Let's do the following. Share this video on your social media profiles, on Twitter, on Facebook, with a quote from this video or with your comment to this video. And of course, share a link to this video so your friends, your loved ones can watch this video. One day they will thank you for that. Among the best shares, the most creative, the most successful shares, I will choose one, and to the author I will give away one copy of the special edition of the bestseller I have co-authored with Brian Tracy. Brian Tracy is the best business teacher and the best personal performance trainer in the world. This special edition looks like that, and you will get my personal dedication. So it's worth trying. On this channel, I share my thoughts, my experiences in doing the impossible. I share also the secret knowledge of the best entrepreneurs in the world, of the self-made billionaires who I have interviewed and extracted their methods of how they think and how they act. So it's worth watching. I encourage you to watch my other videos. Here you will find some of my best videos. That's it from Bahamas. I wish you a fantastic day. Let's do something extraordinary today.